So my name is Rebecca Thomas. I think most of you know that by this point. And I am one of the organizers of this symposium also. But I do have my own little presentation to give as well. The title of it is Opening Up a World of Opportunity. And I am a Hampshire College graduate. I studied, as many of you probably know, Hampshire doesn't exactly have majors, but my concentration was looking at the intersections of environmental issues and social justice. And towards the end of my time at Hampshire, I ended up focusing especially on agriculture and food systems and looking at those in terms of sustainability and social justice. So when I graduated from Hampshire in 2011, I expected that most likely I would find a job that had something to do with agriculture and food systems, food justice, or possibly the environment, since those were the areas that I had studied and that also seemed to be kind of popular areas for NGOs to be focusing on at the time. But things didn't work out quite the way that I had expected, and it turned out that the job I actually got was at the Five College Center for the Study of World Languages. So I was not a language major at Hampshire, or that wasn't my concentration, and I didn't speak really any of the specific languages that are offered in the courses at the Five College Language Center, which are all less commonly taught languages like Swahili, Hindi, Thai, and many other languages. But I did have a strong interest and experience with language study and with study abroad as well. And I think those experiences really helped me stand out in the application process for the job at the Language Center. I had studied Spanish and French to a pretty high level. I picked up a little bit of Guarani during a high school year abroad in Paraguay. And also learned a little bit of Wolof when I was in Senegal for a semester during college. So although I didn't have a lot of skills in the particular languages that were offered at the Language Center in the courses or that were involved in the project I was going to be working on, I did have a lot of experience with learning languages. So I knew what it's like to learn a language and had strong interest in languages and cultures. So I was able to show that in that application process and ended up getting the job. And even though it wasn't quite what I had expected that I was gonna be doing, it worked out really well because I enjoyed the job, the work was interesting, I met a lot of people from different countries and different cultures, and I was always learning something new about other languages, about other cultures. So it was a lot of fun. And at the same time, I also felt like this work was important because I was able to see how language study opened up a lot of opportunities for the students that took our courses. So as many of the other presenters have demonstrated, there's a lot of opportunities that students can get to study abroad, to get scholarships, to do research where they use their language skills, and to get internships, fellowships, and jobs with the help of those language skills. So eventually I started thinking about how my own language skills could open up other opportunities for me as well. And I decided to apply for a Fulbright scholarship to spend a year teaching English in Ecuador. Because I was applying for an English teaching assistant program specifically, I think it was helpful that I did have some experience with teaching English. I had done some volunteer tutoring, and I'd also completed a certificate course in teaching English to speakers of other languages. But it was also critical that I knew Spanish, because the program in Ecuador at that time required applicants to have an advanced level of Spanish. So as part of the application process for Fulbright, I had to fill out a language self-evaluation form, and I also had to have an evaluation done by a professional language teacher. And at the time that I was applying to Fulbright, I also was taking Quechua classes at UMass. And Quechua is an indigenous language that's spoken in the Andean region, including in Ecuador. And that particular language was not required for the application. The requirement was just for Spanish. But I think it did help demonstrate my interest in Andean culture. So hopefully helped my application to stand out a little bit in that way as well. Fulbright programs in different countries have different requirements, so language proficiency isn't always required. I know, for example, Malaysia has English teaching assistant program there where they don't require every applicant to have a proficiency in Malay when they're applying. But I think even when it's not required, it's always helpful to know some of the language before you go. In my experience, I was speaking Spanish every day. I used it to communicate with the professors that I was working with at the university, with students that I was teaching, and I also was involved in some other activities outside of my English teaching assistant duties. I played my oboe with an orchestra, and the rehearsals were all led in Spanish. And I also continued taking Quechua classes in Ecuador, and those classes were taught in Spanish. I also use Spanish to communicate with friends and to talk with my host family, and even just navigating the basic necessities of life, taking a taxi, going to the bank, going shopping, would have been very difficult if I didn't know Spanish. And having the chance to spend that year in Ecuador was really a wonderful opportunity. I was able to get real-life teaching experience and get to know another country and culture. I was living in the Andes Mountains and also had a chance to travel to the coastal region and travel to the Amazon rainforest and even made a trip to the Galapagos Islands. I had new cultural experiences like burning effigies on New Year's Eve, throwing water balloons during Carnival. And perhaps the most special part was the connections that I made with my host family, with the professors that I worked with the students that I taught, friends that I made, and other Fulbrighters that I met through the program. There were 7 of us English teaching assistants in Ecuador that year, and some of us were interested in careers and education, but others had plans to go to medical school or to law school or to pursue other fields after that year in Ecuador. And there were also different paths that had brought us to Ecuador in the first place. We had studied at different colleges, we had different majors and interests, but one thing that we all had in common was that we had to know Spanish in order to get there. Thank you.